During the last video, we talked about our traffic light finite state machine and the difference between a Mealy and a Moore finite state machine. But what we really want to do is we want to implement a controller for this. So to take a step back and think about classes and Java for a moment, we're going to say our system and our controller are separate. What our system does is it sends these sensor signals out to the controller. The controller uses a field called state to keep track of which state it's in, and a method called signal, which is updated and triggered every time a new sensor signal is retrieved. The logic in the controller then applies actions back to the system. And we can think about this in terms of classes and structures, which we'll come back to a wee bit later on. So because we're going to talk about implementation, let's start with a little simpler finite state machine than we have. We're going to do a very, very simple traffic light controller, which you can see in front of you there. If we take this and implement it in Java, it will look like this. We can see we have a class called controller. Within this, we have a system called system, and in this case, our system is just the thing being controlled. Then we have a field called state, which contains a string, this thing here, and that is simply the name of the current state. And by updating this variable called state, we can change the current state of our system. Then within this method, the signal method, which is called with a new sensor variable every time the sensor is triggered or changed, we have the logic of our finite state machine. The logic of our finite state machine is simply nested if statements. First, we check what state we are in. Then, we check what signal has been triggered. And then we go back and check against our diagram for the actions that need to occur, and then what state we need to transition into. If that sensor has not triggered, then we go and check against other sensors, and finally we wrap up by going and checking if all the other states that we are in. So simply, you describe this as having a nested if-else statement, where we check what state we are in, and then we check against all the transitions out of that state. Implementation-wise, that is reasonably simple, and again, you can check what needs to happen by looking at a table of states and possible inputs. Just to be clear, this example of using the Mealy finite state machine for before, those ready and change states that we put in, they are remembering what factors have appeared in the past. They are acting as memory. This is really specifically what each of those states is saying about the past situation of the controller. But what happens if we add additional sensors? This might in turn add additional states. So let's add some pedestrians and some right-hand lanes onto our finite state machine. What would happen? Well, now we have a bunch more controllers. Now we have a bunch more sensors, sorry. We could transition into a variety of different states. In fact, we can transition to a total of 6 different states depending on what sensor is triggered when we're just in the east-west go state. If we need to remember which sensor has triggered and in which order, then each one of those states that we've just produced will also produce another 6 states coming off from them, and we rapidly end up with this massive mess of states just to remember all the sensors that we have. It's actually 2 to the power of the number of sensors that we have, and so rapidly our finite state machine can become untenable because of the high number of states that it has. So what do we do? We have to keep those duplicate states, or we will lose our ability to remember information about the past states of the machine. The solution is to add state variables, little Boolean tags that remember which sensors have triggered and which sensors have not.